Hey everybody, welcome back to the Sony Music Archives. I'm Tom Tierney, and today we are here to celebrate the life and music of Sony Music's and LegacyRecordings.com's Artist of the Month for July 2013, Harry Nilsson. And I am personally really excited about this month because he's one of my favorite artists. And also, Sony Music is bringing out a long-awaited box set of all of Harry's RCA albums from 1967 to 1977, along with tons of other stuff that nobody's ever heard before. I thought that we could bring out some materials related to Harry, just to give you an example of the sort of things that the producers of this set will come to the library and check out in order to get information about the recordings, the release dates, and pretty much everything related to Harry and his recordings for RCA Victor. Just to give you a sense of what the sort of things that the researchers and producers will be seeing, we'll start off with this title, one of my favorites, which is Harry's Son of Schmilson from 1972, just one of my favorite records of all time. Came out in mid-72, follow-up to Harry's huge smash hit Nilsson Schmilson from the previous year. And this document right here is what we would call an artist recording page. And the page itself lists the recording dates and all sorts of other information about these recordings. And this particular page I love because it has three of my favorite songs from this album: Joy, Turn On Your Radio, and the notorious You're Breaking My Heart, all listed here with their recording dates of May 72. Right on the right here, you can see that we have listed all of the performers on these songs in addition to Harry. And we have lists of names like Klaus Voormann, George Harrison, Peter Frampton, Nicky Hopkins, just an incredible list of performers on these titles. And this is the sort of stuff that the researchers who work on sets like this come down and get, and so all that information comes in the booklet and everything else related to Harry's recordings. We have a selection of different Harry-related materials, some classic albums, an original quad release of Nilsson Schmilsson, which is exceptionally rare these days. One last thing I wanted to show you before we said goodbye is we have here an original 45 release of the Nilsson song Without You, which was, of course, his biggest hit, his only number one hit in the U.S., and I show it to you just to give you a sense of what this 45 looked like when it hit stores in late 1971. And also just to give you a look at this fabulous company sleeve for RCA. If you're too young to remember what things looked like in 1971, this is what they looked like back then. Again, July 2013, Artist of the Month, Harry Nilsson. We're celebrating him all month long on LegacyRecordings.com with lots of information, pictures, and also information about the new box set from Legacy Recordings, Harry Nilsson, the RCA Albums Collection. Thanks for watching. Again, I'm Tom Tierney here in the Sony Music Archives, and I'll see you next time on LegacyRecordings.com.